This hour brought to you by GCNLife.com. Live younger, look younger, feel younger at GCNLife.com.
The stocks discussed on Wall Street Raw are not in any way a recommendation or solicitation to buy, sell, or hold. If considering on acting on information, we first recommend you seek out a competent, licensed professional for advice.
What kingdom has sent you?
The kingdom of the Most High.
Nothing you have ever experienced can prepare you for the unbridled carnage you're about to witness. The Super Bowl, the World Series, they don't know what pressure is. In this building, it's either kill or be killed. You make no friends in the pits and you take no prisoners. 1 minute, you're up half a million in soybeans, and the next, boom, your kids don't go to college and they've repossessed your Bentley. Are you with me?
Genesis Communication Network is proud to bring you Wall Street Raw with nationally recognized market timer and previous Wall Street Week elf, Mark Liebovan, welcoming you on board his financial time machine. And here is the elf himself, Mark Liebovan.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Welcome to Wall Street Raw on this Saturday, the 20th of October. We appreciate you tuning in on a Saturday morning. Obviously, you have a lot of other choices, and this is one of the more popular shows on a Saturday morning for Wall Street, so I'm told. So I'm very happy, and we are expanding our network a little bit. Those who may, few may not know me, I've been around about four decades running my stock market newsletter, VRTrader.com. Used to be the Volume Reversal Survey way back in the late 70s, early 80s. Other of you may know me from the old Louis Rukeyser days, where I was fortunate enough to be chosen as an elf for about 10 years on his program. And for about 30 years, I worked with Paul Kangas on the Nightly Business Report as a market monitor guest. I encourage you to go to VRTrader.com for more information. We do our best on our show to try to bring you a variety of guests in the market. We cover, you know, everything from politics to economics to individual stock picks. And one of our very special guests that we have on the show as regularly as we can is our good friend Harry Boxer from the TechTrader.com. Harry Boxer has been doing this probably as long or longer than I have, and he's one of the best stock pickers out there. And I encourage you to go to his website, TheTechTrader.com, for more information and also a free trial. Good morning, Harry. Thank you for joining us.
My pleasure for being here as usual. We got an interesting market, don't we?
No question about it. We've hit the October crash time frame scenario. Everybody was looking for September and discounting October, and suddenly they pulled the plug in October. What's your reading?
Well, we've at least had wave one and two if we're going to have a massive sell-off. But that big negative tick we had on Thursday of minus 1,500 encouraged me to go long. I thought the rally was going to ensue. But we reached a level at which there was a nice Fibonacci retracement levels that were achieved. Now they pulled back to retest and did a Fibonacci pullback retrace and bounce today. But you can see we're selling off here. We're not far from – we're actually at the lows for the day on NASDAQ 100. We're still up 32, but if we were up like 80 or 90, and maybe that was over 100 at one point. So the bottom line is, you know, we have a nasty little sell-off underway. The market is extremely volatile. Tech stocks are really hurting. I just put out a short on Intuitive Surgical, ISRG. I feel after running up, exploding up near 540, it's trading at 505, and it's had a nasty reversal from up 30 to down 16. If you look at the daily chart, it looks like a top is forming, and this could plunge in here. If we get any kind of market sell-off, that's one of my current swing shorts. On the long side, we still have stocks every day that look like they're day traders. In particular, last three sessions in a row, we've had stocks up multiple 100% more or 300% type gains for day trades. So we look for those stocks that are trending during the day, and we've been very successful so far in the last three sessions. I don't remember the last time we had three days in a row where we had three stocks that went up to 300% in one day. So it's pretty interesting.
I want to remind our listeners that we're taping this interview on Friday the 19th, so some of the prices that you might hear may differ from the closing price on Friday. Harry, so let's talk about some of the key sectors out there. For example, let's start with my favorite, the cannabis sector. Huge move to the upside, but looks like they may have blown off a little bit temporarily with the news from Canada coming midweek.
Yeah, I agree. It's still the news, but they did break out. Look at CGC, my favorite, which I first started recommending in the mid-teens. It traded up to 60, 59 and change. And now it's pulled back to 48 and change. And, you know, it looks to me like we may have had a head fake, meaning they've all popped out on that news. Now they pull back. I want to see what support tells me here. The other one I like is ACBFF. At least that's holding up flat for the day. And there's several stocks in the group that I like, but those are the two stocks that I follow the closest, CGC and ACBFF, which is going to be listed, by the way, in the New York Stock Exchange, and their symbol is ACB, I think, starting next week.
Yeah, there's rumors out there or discussion that these big companies are still talking to some big U.S. companies. We know CGC works with Constellation Brands, and there's been discussion that they could even take a bigger investment position. I always felt, Harry, that they're going to take the company out completely. STZ, Constellation would take out CGC completely just from the get-go. I don't think they take that type of investment position just for a trade. You know, I think they're going to ultimately acquire.
Well, you have to understand that you may be right, but at the same point, the company may not want to be acquired, and they're willing to get an investment to raise capital for expansion purposes, but they, you know, it depends on where management's at. They may not want to be acquired. It could be interesting. Meanwhile, I just want to point out, though, that the tech stocks, the big boys, the FANG stocks, look ugly and thin, and for me, this could be the beginning of a pretty nasty decline. The only proviso I have, that my buddy Avi Gilbert over at Every Wave Trader is a real good Every Wave guy. He thinks there may be one more snapback surge, even to new highs, before they roll them over big time. But he's looking for 20-25% down this year, and I don't disagree with that. So you got to get defensive and protective.
So what he's saying is, and there's a lot of thought about that, I sort of share that view. We have a pullback maybe into the election and then a big year-end rally, and after that, the party's over. That kind of thinking, huh?
Yep, exactly. And so I'm getting, every day I put out big box of shorts. I put out defensive day trades like the UVXY, TVIX, but yesterday were monster trades for us. Right now, as the market, as we speak, we're getting a pretty decent pullback to the special lows. If you look at the daily chart on TVIX, for example, it's been in a downtrend since it reached literally 170. I think that may have been a reverse split, which it usually does. But coming down to the mid-20s, it's now exploded to over 50 and backed off. So right now at 41, this might be the entry point. If the market's going lower, at least short-term, these could really be interesting. My only hesitancy is it's so volatile and there's doubles and triples in terms of the ETF expansions. They are dangerous for more than a day trade.
Harry, gold's come back to life a little bit. Nothing extraordinary, but it has been creeping up there. So it looks like it may have temporarily bottomed just at a time when cycle said it wouldn't. It's interesting.
It is interesting. My only problem with it is that I don't think they're quite ready yet. I think they bottomed. The question is, what are they going to do now? If they take a look at Nugget or JNOW, they popped out of base patterns and they're wedging or coiling in here, which could be very bullish. I don't look at the GLD or the GDX as much. They don't look as good. Just a quick look at the GDX. Yeah. Same pattern. Little base, inverse head and shoulders, a breakout, and now a platform or flag, which all goes well from one upside. On the GDX, for example, the VanEck Vectors Gold Miners ETF, it's at around 20. My targets are 23 and 25 going forward. But, again, this is not exactly a tech stock. And so gold, I think, individually, you may want to look at certain gold stocks like ABX, American Barracks, or Royal Gold. I like that one a lot. A few others in that group, Newmont Mining, NEM, AU, which is the South African gold miner, I think Rand. Anglo Gold, Ashanti. That's got a beautiful, take a look at that chart in particular, beautiful inverse head and shoulders and breakout. So that one may have already bottomed and is on its way higher. And that's a cheap stock, under $7, under 10. And
Harry,
the X is also pretty
good. We ran out of time. Harry Boxer from thetechtrader.com. If you want more information, go to thetechtrader.com. Harry, we'll talk to you next week. Thank you.
You're listening to Wall Street Raw with Mark Leibovitz. Go to WallStreetRawRadio.com for information on Mark's newsletters and products. Stay tuned. Mark will be right back.
Water is the single most important thing your body needs, so you want to be sure it's the best for you and your family. Since 2005, thousands have depended on Berkey Purified Water. The Berkey guy provides the lowest price filtration systems in every size. For incredibly delicious water now and in an emergency, get to GoBerkey.com or call 877-886-3653. 877-886-3653. GoBerkey.com.
Marijuana has unleashed a green gold rush across our nation. It's creating $10.8 billion in new wealth a year. And every day, it's transforming more and more Americans into millionaires. In an historic event, former Speaker of the House John Boehner reveals how you could become one of them. Join him online for the American Cannabis Summit. Attendance is 100% free, but space is limited. To secure your spot, text JOIN to 44055. This event is the first of its kind ever. John Boehner and an esteemed panel will reveal which cannabis stocks are primed to deliver life-changing windfalls in the weeks and months ahead. Plus, they will show you how to become a cannabis angel investor, backing the hottest startups before they potentially become worth billions of dollars. To join American Cannabis Summit, text JOIN to 44055. Attendance is free. Text JOIN to 44055.
Most of you know that heart disease is the number one silent killer in the U.S. What if I told you for just $54.95 a month you could fight against heart disease naturally? At Heart and Body Extract, we've been helping thousands of people get back to a healthier heart. Don't just take my word for it. Check out all of the success stories at hbextract.com. Or to order, call 866-295-5305. That's 866-295-5305. hbextract.com. Don't risk it when you can take charge of it.
Do the letters IRS give you anxiety? I'm Dan Pilla. I've defended people from the IRS for more than 40 years. My book, How to Get Tax Amnesty, created the tax resolution industry and is responsible for helping hundreds of thousands of people. It can help you too. If you're a non-filer or facing IRS enforcement right now, your case is unique. You need real help, not cookie cutter advice. My clients get my personal attention. Buy my book at danpilla.com and get a free consultation directly with me. That's danpilla.com. Let's start solving your tax problem right now.
Hello, I'm Mike Lindell, the inventor of My Pillow, and like all of you out there, I had problems sleeping. Pillows would go flat, I would flip-flop all night long, I would wake up with a sore neck, maybe a headache, or feel like I needed a nap even though I slept 8 hours. When I invented My Pillow, I wanted it to where you could move the patented fill to give you the exact support you need as an individual, regardless of sleep position. My Pillow will get you into that deep REM sleep faster, and you will stay there longer. It's not about how much time we spend in bed, it's about how much of that quality sleep we get. I do all of my own manufacturing right here in the United States. I have a 10-year warranty. You can wash and dry my pillow, and I give you a 60-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. And here's my best offer ever. You can buy one of my pillows and get one absolutely free.
Go to MyPillow.com or call 800-870-0305 and use promo code GCN. That's MyPillow.com or 800-870-0305 with promo code GCN.
By now you know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Lockheed Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. LockheedPocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at LockheedPocket.com or call 888-315-9618. LockheedPocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
Never show any sign of weakness. Always go for the throat. Buy low, sell high. Fear, that's the other guy's problem.
Welcome back to the Wall Street Raw Radio Show with Mark Leibovitz, your time machine for the financial markets. Want to know more? Go to WallStreetRawRadio.com.
Now, here's the elf himself, Mark Leibovitz.
Welcome back to Wall Street Raw on this Saturday, the 20th of October. And I want to thank, of course, Harry Boxer for spending a few minutes with us. And as a reminder, those quotes and so forth are from a Friday taping, even though we're live here Saturday morning. So the exact prices would differ a little bit. But we don't have a market on Saturday, so we catch Harry on Friday when we can look at the charts. A lot going on in the market. In the last part of our interview, we were talking about the gold stocks and gold, which look like they've bottomed at least temporarily here. I don't know if a big move is coming or not. We have been long at VRTrader.com and in our VR Gold letter as well, and we'll see how far this goes. Cycles tend to be positive in gold into February, though sometimes they make a little low in mid-December. But if you look at the cyclical patterns in gold, that's it. But how far we're going to go is a big question. I've been speculating that maybe we can get up to about 1275. We were down about 1170 when we bottomed a few weeks ago. And it would take a big move. It would take a move above 1375 before we could start talking about the resumption of a bull market. My personal feeling is the big move is probably a couple years away. This is probably just a nice trade. But we try to trade them, and this doesn't deter, I suppose, some of those of you who want to keep some coins in the vault and just have some gold for the sake of having gold or silver. Silver is also relatively cheap. But I think on a long haul, you're probably okay. My big fear, and I'm not trying to create the panic here of any kind, is that if we do back off through that 1170 low we saw in recent weeks, there could be risk to new lows in gold back down to 1,000 an ounce or even under that in the next couple of years. So nothing guaranteed there, just some speculation on my part, and we will trade them, of course, as we see them. It was an exciting week in the cannabis sector, and as probably most of you know, I'm pretty involved with that, both in terms of trading and investments and so forth, and we've been involved since 2014 when we really got involved in the sector. What's so exciting is that it's really become legitimate now. You know, big companies like Constellation Brands taking a position in Canopy Growth, that's ticker symbol CGC in Canada, several billion dollars, and in fact, and with the option to invest even more. Exciting was a rumor out in recent couple of weeks that Aurora Cannabis, he was talking to Coca-Cola that there might be some deal there. Came out in the last week, about a week and a half ago, that and then by the way, it's ACBFF, by the way, if you're looking for the NASDAQ symbol, Fria, APHQF. There was a story in the Globe and Mail in Canada about Philip Morris in discussions with them, and the company has not confirmed that, but there's all these stories out there, and then it makes sense. You know, when I started the Cannabis Vice letter, you know, I had names like Philip Morris in there, and you know, many of the big tobacco names, liquor names, and so forth, thinking that these are the companies that would ultimately get involved. It turned out it was the liquor companies first, and we now know that Molson Coors, that's ticker symbol TAP, T-A-P, has invested in the Canadian company HYYDF. I know it's sort of a tricky symbol there, and that that's Hexo Corp, H-E-X-O Corp in Canada. It's a little $5 stock. So Molson Coors is involved, and we know Constellation Brands is involved, and you know, others in the industry are going to get involved up there. And I guess it's obvious why. I mean, these companies, particularly in the liquor sector, have the distribution, and they've dealt with government regulations having to do with a substance such as liquor, beer, alcohol, and so forth, that, you know, have restrictions on them in terms of sales and so forth over the years. And they have the wherewithal to really take something like cannabis and make it work. And what they're trying to do, as you probably know, is create cannabis-infused beverages, not necessarily combining alcohol with it, just in a beverage that would have some THC in it and, I guess, CBD as well. So, you know, very, you know, exciting opportunity there. And, you know, they're doing it. Why? Because they think that beer sales or liquor sales might back off a little bit, or they just want to diversify into a fast-growing market. And by doing it in Canada, which really, as most of you may or may not know, is really international in terms of what they're doing. The companies are just not in Canada, which is a relatively small population, 30-some, 30-40 million people. We're talking about international deals, Australia, Germany, Uruguay, Portugal, Netherlands, all over the globe, and Canadians are international to begin with. If you know anything about Canadians, and I have the luck of dealing with many of them, particularly in Vancouver, when I do the annual World Outlook Conference up there, which I've done for several years as a keynote speaker, they are international. They travel the world. The geologists that are trained up there in the mining sector, for example. So the advantage that Canada now has over the U.S. because of our restrictive marijuana laws here in terms of, you know, banking and in terms of full legalization have put a competitive advantage much in their favor. So there's still plenty of opportunity there. You know, Canada went legal with recreational, as you know, midweek this past week. These stocks are already really high. Many are still holding many of their gains, but you got to trade them. Obviously, a lot's been discounted here in the last few years. For example, Canopy Growth, which is now around $50 a share. I remember we were recommending it at $2 when it started back in 2014 when they first went public. So obviously a lot of profit has already been made here, so I'm not recommending chasing them, but we do have a core portfolio that we've been in for a while, the Cannabis Vice Letter, and we do trade few, and there's always new ones coming on board. And just think, you know, when the deal is made, let's say between a Coca-Cola and a Aurora Cannabis or a Philip Morris and an Aphria, you know, look at the potential there for both companies looking at a multi-year basis. So a lot of potential there, and we are doing our best to try to stay on top of it. We feel like there's still many trading opportunities in that sector, and if we get a little shakeout in them, I still think there's a play here. So we're not giving up on it at all because of the stock market. And if you probably noticed, even with the stock market having corrected and had a nice sell-off here in the last couple of weeks, most of these names have held up pretty well, and that's also encouraging because it's a different market. You know, it's almost like saying SIN stocks, you know, do well when the regular market goes down. There have been funds, as you probably know, that invest in tobacco and alcohol and gaming, and the thought is that when things get bad, people populate those companies in those sectors. So gaming, I don't think, is going to get involved in cannabis so fast, but I guess that's always a possibility. But we now know it's alcohol and tobacco. So I encourage you to go to VRTrader.com and take a look at the Cannabis Vice Letter. A lot of opportunities there, and something I think that you got to be really thinking about in terms of diversifying your portfolio, just like you would with gold or any other asset. On the show today, we hope to have a very special guest coming up, Dinesh D'Souza, who we've had on the show before, so we're going to try to reach him later in the program. And, of course, my good friend Sinclair Noe is going to be joining us, so don't touch your dial. You're listening to Wall Street Raw.
Go to WallStreetRawRadio.com for more information on Mark's newsletters and products. Stay tuned. Mark will be right back.
High-performance investors and traders use superior financial tools to achieve superior returns. You have that tool with Mark Leibovit, nationally renowned top market timer, legendary television Wall Street Week elf, and nightly business report market monitor, who shares with you his unique market tools and commentary at WallStreetRaw.com. At WallStreetRaw.com, Mark provides you with his latest ideas on how to help build and protect your wealth and help you avoid the next big market crash. Mark has a special free gift for listeners of his Wall Street Raw radio show. Go to WallStreetRaw.com and sign up for his free monthly Cannabis Vice News Raw report. While there, go ahead and sign up for his free monthly Gold News Raw report. Both are totally free. No credit card information is required. Sign up today for your free Cannabis Vice News Raw and Gold News Raw reports at WallStreetRaw.com. That's WallStreetRaw.com.
Attention business owners and independent contractors. This is a money-saving message from Tax Mediation Services. If your business owes $20,000 or more in taxes, we can help you today, right now. Listen, dealing with the IRS is no picnic. It's an intimidating and extremely stressful process, and you don't want to go it alone. Our attorneys know every law, every tax break, and every possible opportunity to help you resolve and reduce your tax debt. And if you owe more than $20,000, you may be at the top of their hit list. So don't take your tax debt lightly, because it will not go away on its own. The IRS can seize your bank accounts, your home, and even shut down your business. Call our tax experts today at 1-800-318-4349 and let us deal with the IRS while you focus on your business. That's 1-800-318-4349. Again, that's 800-318-4349.
Have you checked your Google search results lately? Search results are usually the first impression that people form of you or your business. So make sure that they create a positive impression with ReputationDefender.com. What the internet says about you can have a big impact on your life and your livelihood, even if it's not true. Fortunately, you can now control how you look online and in online search results with ReputationDefender.com. Call 800-831-0771 now. That's 800-831-0771 for your free reputation analysis. If you have negative material from an ex-employee, upset patient, or former client, newspaper article, legal issue, social media, or other source showing up in your search results, you can combat it with ReputationDefender.com. Our dedicated experts in patented technology can help make your online search results look their best. Call 800-831-0771 to learn more. 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771. Or visit ReputationDefender.com.
Pain in my neck, back, and shoulders has really gotten worse.
Relief for body pain is here with Sunny Bay Heating Pads.
Well, the last thing I want is to take another pill, so what's so good about Sunny Bay Heating Pads?
Sunny Bay Heating Pads, made by Biomed DB Design right here in the USA, come in all sizes. Our extra-large microwavable heating pad for back pain is designed to be large enough to cover your entire back. It's also perfect to wrap around your legs, knees, or shoulder and neck.
But I need to know they're good quality.
Of course. Sunny Bay heating pads and pillows are often an Amazon choice, and it's easy and most affordable when you purchase your Sunny Bay heating pads right from our website, sunshinepillows.com, or call us 253-678-1361.
Hey, a Sunny Bay heating pad
would make a great gift, right?
Yes, and they start at just $19.99, and free shipping is available. So call 253-678-1361 or shop for your Sunny Bay heating pad at sunshinepillows.com.
To know more about Wall Street Raw and the Leibovitz VR newsletters, go to WallStreetRawRadio.com.
Welcome back to Wall Street Raw on this Saturday, the 20th of October. And we have a very special guest, a repeat guest on our program. It's really an honor having Dinesh D'Souza with us. Dinesh is a household name, at least around our household. It should be yours as well. Nationally known commentator, conservative columnist. He wrote, "America is the greatest, freest, and most decent society in existence. It is an oasis in the desert of cynicism and barbarism. This country, once an experiment, unique in the world, is now the last best hope for the world." Dinesh, I want to thank you again for joining us. Dinesh has created some of the most popular documentaries in recent history. For example, Hillary's America. I think it was the highest grossing political commentary documentary film of all time. And now his new Death of a Nation, which is available on DVD and streaming, is something you also should see if you have not. Good morning, Dinesh. Thank you for joining us.
Good morning. Great to be on the show.
Well, there's so much to talk about, and we have so little time to talk. Let's talk about the midterms. I mean, the Democrats are out there doing their dirty deeds. We have Antifa out there beating up people, interfering with our normal daily lives, raiding restaurants, following Republicans around. Where are we, Dinesh?
Well, the third real moment of American politics that began with Trump's election in November of 2016 has really remained with us. And I would not have believed it if you had told me that 2 years later we would still be in this kind of fevered moment, but we certainly are. And the midterms, in a way, I think they only make things worse. And I think they make things worse in the sense that if the Democrats are defeated again in their hope to retake the House, possibly retake the Senate. See, I don't think these things are going to happen. And so they're in for a rude shock. And I think this may unfortunately lead to an escalation of their tactics of intimidation, name-calling, incivility, and barbarism on the street.
I know it's just incredible when I see the videos of what's going on, particularly up in Portland and so forth. We talked about this off air. Reminds me of the brown shirts in Nazi Germany. Why aren't our law enforcement officials or the government cracking down on this and dealing with them the way normal law enforcement officials should? For example, the mayor of Portland told the police to stand down.
So this is because Antifa has a secret weapon. And its secret weapon is the collusion of the media, not just the Democratic Party, but also powerful officials in government. At Berkeley, where the Antifa movement really started, the mayor of Berkeley, this guy Jesse Aragon, is a member of one of the Antifa Facebook pages. And so this is the guy who would pull away the cops and let Antifa do its kind of bruising work. And for Antifa, if they're able to intimidate a speaker or chase him off the campus or cause the university to cancel the event, they count that as a success. And so it doesn't do any good to just call for civility or tell them to stop. They're not going to stop as long as those tactics work. And the same thing is true in Portland. The mayor is a kind of Antifa sympathizer, or either that or he's an invertebrate. And so the combination of being a sympathizer or an invertebrate makes these law enforcement officials not do their job.
And we're not even talking about key Democratic leaders encouraging violence. Maxine Waters, for example, which is incredible.
Well, behind this, the Democrats have an argument. What I explore in the latest movie, Death of a Nation, also accompanying book of the same title, it's this. Essentially, the left insists that Trump's election is similar to, let's say, Hitler's election in 1933. Now, Hitler, of course, wasn't elected per se. He was named chancellor, but he acquired power illegally, and the Nazi Party was, in fact, the largest party in Germany at the time. And so for the left, their argument is that if we had been in Nazi Germany at that time and Hitler was democratically elected, we would still be justified in using all kinds of extreme tactics in trying to get rid of him to avert the catastrophes that came later. And so applying this analogy to Trump, they go, well, look, this is why it's justified for us to confront people and threaten them, intimidate them, bully them. This is why it's perfectly okay to use it, what they say, by any means necessary to get rid of Trump. So that's the work that this Nazi analogy does for them. But it's a bogus analogy because Nazism was always on the left. The Nazis were national socialists. Mussolini in Italy, the founder, in a sense, of fascism, was also a left-winger. He was a Marxist in early life, a socialist all his life. And so the leftist roots of fascism and Nazism are being camouflaged by the left in their attempt to pin the fascist tail on the Republican elephant.
We have to hope, of course, that the public, hopefully the independents out there as well, maybe some Democrats, resent this and vote accordingly. And I guess that's what we're talking about here, is that there may be a surprise in November, which we already know the Senate is probably okay, Dinesh, but the House, like you say, could be a surprise. And I'm sort of praying for that and believe that's still possible. I think common sense will rule here, and people, when they get to the voting booth, realize that there's something really bad going on and they need to address it.
Well, this is a case where the historical moment momentum is on the side of the Democrats and all common sense is on the other side. Because I think that people who observe American politics can see, you know, do we actually want this kind of craziness that the Democrats today represent? Stagnant economies, illegals, roaming across the border, horrific crime rates in Democratic-controlled cities, this kind of open defense of lawlessness. I don't think that's the America most people want to live in. So I think for that reason, the historical advantage that the opposition party enjoys in the midterm year is not going to be present this year. Also, the Kavanaugh effect. I mean, it's remarkable. I think there were a lot of Republicans who were uneasy about Trump, and they thought that Democratic attacks on Trump were somewhat justified because Trump is a somewhat shady character. And when they saw that Kavanaugh, a man not only of impeccable intellectual credentials, but a person who's a Boy Scout, someone that was praised by all the people who worked with him for many, many years, as a gentleman, as someone very courteous, a person of moral rectitude, if that guy could be smeared in this kind of unconscionable way, then none of us are safe. So we've had a unifying effect on the Republican Party.
Dinesh, I don't want to leave you without, again, talking about your very successful films and books. Our listeners, if they want to reach you and perhaps purchase the DVD and streaming version of Death of a Nation, is best going to your website? What do you suggest?
Yeah, the movie has a website. It's called deathofanationmovie.com, and you can stream it, of course, on Amazon or iTunes, Google Play, any kind of platform. The DVDs will be in stores very shortly. And it's a very powerful intellectual and emotional narrative that will really give you a sense of the stakes involved and also shows you how history has been manipulated by the progressive left, distorting what actually happened in an attempt to create political gain.
I saw the film. I loved it. It was great. Of course, Hillary's America was terrific as well. Terrific job. Do you have another film in the works?
Well, I probably will do one for the election year of 2020, but right now I'm focusing not just on the movie, but also an accompanying book of the same title, because the movie shows these dramatic scenes. You know, here are a senior Nazi sitting around passing laws to discriminate against Jews, and they have in their hands the democratic laws of the Jim Crow South. Now, all of this is documented in the book, in the accompanying book.
Dinesh D'Souza, thank you for joining us. Have a great day.
My pleasure. Thank you.
You are listening to Wall Street Raw with Mark Liebovit. Go to WallStreetRawRadio.com for information on Mark's newsletters and products. Stay tuned. Mark will be right back.
High-performance investors and traders use superior financial tools to achieve superior returns. You have that tool with Mark Liebovit, nationally renowned top market timer, legendary television Wall Street Week elf, and nightly business report market monitor, who shares with you his unique market tools and commentary at WallStreetRaw.com. Here, Mark provides you with his latest ideas on how to help build and protect your wealth and help you avoid the next big market tsunami. Mark has a special free gift for listeners of his Wall Street Raw radio show. Go to WallStreetRaw.com and sign up for his free monthly Cannabis Vice News Raw report. While there, go ahead and sign up for his free monthly Gold News Raw report. Both are totally free. No credit card information is required, and no one will call. Sign up today for your free Cannabis Vice News Raw report and Gold News Raw report at WallStreetRaw.com.
Heart-related health problems affect millions of people each year. Maybe you're one of the many who suffer from issues related to angina pain, high blood pressure, congestive heart failure, unbalanced cholesterol, irregular heartbeat, or clogged arteries. There is a solution that doesn't involve expensive prescription drugs that only mask the problem and leave you with horrible side effects. If you are ready to live your life free of sickness, pain, and fear, live your life with increased vitality, energy, and youthfulness, and experience your body healing itself.
yourself, then you're ready for Heart and Body Extract from Healthy Hearts Club. Here is what one satisfied customer had to say about Heart and Body Extract regarding his angina pain.
I haven't had an angina pain since I've been on it. The Heart Body Extract is just so great. I thank God that I was led to this product that's doing so much for me and that can do so much for other people.
Call to order your 2-month supply of Heart and Body Extract today. Call 1-866-295-5305 or go to hbextract.com.
It's a no-brainer. A Big Berkey water filter is the one you need, period. You need a water filter that removes chlorine, fluoride, pharmaceuticals, BPA, and other endocrine disruptors, pesticides, bacteria, viruses, and much more, right? And does it all at only 2 cents per gallon. Get the original and most trusted name in gravity water filtration, Big Berkey. And now GCN listeners receive 5% off ceramic filter systems using code GCN. Call or click 1-877-99-BERKEY or BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. That's 1-877-99-BERKEY.
Times are changing. The circus of politics, healthcare's low standards and high prices, and let's not forget food quality. What to do? Arm yourself with Life Change Tea at GetTheTea.com. In a world of chemical imbalance and poor air and water quality, it's time you make a move. Log on to GetTheTea.com and stock up on organic non-GMO supplements. Don't forget the tea. Cleansing your body never felt so good. And we have a brand new tea called Takedown Tea, which helps support healthy glucose. All natural body support so you can be at your best, naturally. All you have to do is log on to GetTheTea.com. That's GetTheTea.com. We're not a fad that comes and goes. We are the real deal. Join us and armor up. GetTheTea.com. That's GetTheTea.com. Changing America's health one tea bag at a time.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and sling bows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Responsibility begins and ends with our partners and our shareholders, and that's it.
There is no freedom without the law.
Get it? Got it? Good.
Welcome back to Wall Street Raw and the final segment with Mark Leibovit. Now, here's the elf himself.
Welcome back to Wall Street Raw on this 20th of October, 2018. We always try to save the best for last, as my good friend Sinclair know, from 1510 a.m. in Phoenix and author of the incomparable blog, eatthebankers.com. It's that time again.
It's time for another edition of
Banks Behaving Badly.
Sinclair, I want to thank you again for joining us on this Saturday morning.
Well, thank you. Always a pleasure. Thank you, Mark.
Okay, so the ex-Deutsche Banker traders, they're guilty of the U.S. LIBOR rigging trial. No surprise there, right?
Not really. These were a couple of former traders at Deutsche Bank. Convicted in New York. The idea is that they conspired to rig LIBOR, and some of these folks who have been involved in the LIBOR rigging cases, it looks a little bit like the Keystone Cops at times. But apparently they were rigging the LIBOR rate, which is a key interest rate benchmark. It's a global benchmark that basically kind of tells you, based out of London, what the official rates are going to be. And surprise, surprise, it's been abused by a bunch of banks over the years.
And it will continue to be abused, I'm sure, going forward, knowing our history with the bankers, right?
Yeah. Deutsche Bank and Barclays have already paid out $9 billion in fines just related to LIBOR. And several that probably a couple dozen traders have been fined on this, and a few have gone to jail as well. So,
you know, the average person out there probably doesn't even know what LIBOR is. That's probably the honest truth. You know, the average guy in the street would know an interest rate from a LIBOR. So this is more intellectual than anything else. I think that's the problem, is that it's at such a level it doesn't seem to affect the thought process of the average person. You know what I mean? It's not. It's important we understand that, but it's too esoteric, I think, for them. Meanwhile, let's talk about the Federal Reserve. We had the minutes of the Federal Open Market Committee were released this week. So they're still convinced they want to raise rates.
Apparently so. That seems to be the path that we are on. There is nothing to indicate that the Fed is going to deviate from that path unless there's a significant change in data. But right now, the data is coming in exactly as the Federal Reserve might anticipate. We've got a strong labor market. We've got a few indications of inflation, but not running wild at this point. This is about as good as you could hope for the Fed to do, and yet, as you know, the Fed is being chastised for raising rates.
You're going too far too fast, right?
Right, which, you know, I get it. That's always going to be the case until such time as it's a perfectly executed soft landing, which has never happened, by the way. So, yeah, there's probably going to be a little bit of difficulty in touching down on this. It'll probably result in a recession, whether it's big and bad or short and not so bad. That's the question. But I don't see how the Federal Reserve gets out of this without slowing down the economy to the point of recession.
Yeah, we hope it's not the old Alan Greenspan slam on the brake, slam on the accelerator approach. That's for sure. But
well, Greenspan was notorious for that. I mean, it just, if you were in that car, you were getting thrown all about. And I have to say, since Bernanke, we've seen the Fed do a much better job of relating what they're going to do. No surprises, no drama.
Right. They do telegraph their intentions well ahead of time. So we'll find out, you know, whether their higher rates really impact the market as we fear, or maybe the normalization will be absorbed. You know, only time will tell. A lot of bears out there prowling around telling us to watch out big, but it has impacted some real estate deals. I've heard that for sure, you know, so we'll find out.
I would not be surprised. We're already starting to see real estate slow down. Residential real estate, for example, is slowing down. It's not that people don't want to buy. They do. Or that they don't want to sell. They do. It's just that it's gotten a little bit more difficult right now. Prices are not holding up as firm as they were 6 months ago. So it's a little bit of a challenge. And, you know, we'll see. You've got the higher interest rates. We've got trade wars going on with China, to a certain extent, Canada, Mexico, and the European Union. You got the Federal Reserve tightening, getting out of the bond buying business, and also raising rates back to what they would consider more normal levels. All this going on, and we're supposed to believe that it's not going to slow down the economy. At some point, it will slow the economy. That's what it's intended to do, and that's what it will do. So for me, it's just a matter of time. I think that what we're seeing now in on Wall Street with the trading that we've seen lately, this is the warning shot. This is saying get ready. Things are going to start moving around a little bit. That doesn't mean that they're going to start moving on Monday, but they've already started moving. We could have a long period where it settles down, but I think this is telling us we're closer to the end than we are to the beginning of this cycle.
Right, and you wrote that a record 85% of fund managers surveyed by the Bank of America of Merrill Lynch said they think the global economy is in a late cycle.
I think so. I mean, I just don't see how it is not. And, you know, we're looking at a variety of things that come together. I don't see how we don't slow down the economy in this process. The tax cuts, we'll see how those play in a few more months. We don't really know yet, but right now it looks like it was mainly tax cuts for corporations, not for regular individuals. There may be some benefits there. Let's hope so. But that wasn't enough. So what else is out there that can keep this thing floating along? Well, we'll see.
Well, we have the midterm elections coming up here in less than 3 weeks, and you know, the fear that the House is taken by the Democrats and a lot of the tax advantages that were created, whether corporate or individual, might be reversed, and you know, that's weighing on the market here. I think, as you and I know, though, we've been around a long time. We've seen bull markets both in Democratic and Republican administrations, bear markets, bull markets. In fact, the biggest crashes were during Herbert Hoover, which was Republican, and Ronald Reagan. So there's no guarantee the market will go down because the House changes, but I think the market would be a little unnerved by that.
I think so. The market always gets unnerved by uncertainty, and that's what we would be looking at in the midterms. You know, little uncertainty isn't always a bad thing, though. We'll just have to see how it plays out. And at this point, boy, if you know the answer, lay down some bets, because nobody seems to be real confident of what direction we're headed here.
Right, that overnight trading on the night of election results, like we saw in the on the big presidential election, was wild. If you remember, if that repeats, we're going to have some wild trading coming up here in the next couple, 3 weeks for sure.
We very well might, but I think right now it's just a little bit of a reality shock. Yes, the Fed is tightening. Yes, we are heading into an election. Yes, a lot of things are going on that need to be priced into this market, and slowly but surely it's happening.
Sinclair, I want to really thank you again for joining us. Sinclair Ngo from KFNN 1510 and author of the incomparable blog eatthebankers.com. Sinclair, I want you to have a great weekend, and I want to thank you so much for joining us.
Mark, always a pleasure. Thank you.
And I want to remind all of you out there, if you haven't heard it several times already on the show, one of my heroes in the business was Ed Hart at the old Financial News Network back out in Oceanside, California, back in the 1980s, actually 1970s. And he used to close his show, as we do here, with the phrase, "We will know in the fullness of time." Thank you again, and thank you for joining Wall Street Raw.
Thank you for listening to Wall Street Raw with nationally recognized market timer and previous Wall Street Week Alf, Mark Leibovitz. If you missed any of today's show or to get in touch with Mark, please go to WallStreetRawRadio.com. Any stocks or investment discussed on Wall Street Raw are not in any way a recommendation or solicitation to buy, sell, or hold. We first recommend you seek out a licensed financial professional for advice. Go to WallStreetRawRadio.com for more information on Mark's newsletters and products.
High-performance investors and traders use superior financial tools to achieve superior returns. You have that tool with Mark Leibovitz, nationally renowned top market timer, legendary television Wall Street Week elf, and nightly business report market monitor, who shares with you his unique market tools and commentary at WallStreetRaw.com. At WallStreetRaw.com, Mark provides you with his latest ideas on how to help build and protect your wealth and help you avoid the next big market crash. Mark has a special free gift for listeners of his Wall Street Raw radio show. Go to WallStreetRaw.com and sign up for his free monthly Cannabis Vice News Raw report. While there, go ahead and sign up for his free monthly Gold News Raw report. Both are totally free. No credit card information is required. Sign up today for your free Cannabis Vice News Raw and Gold News Raw reports at WallStreetRaw.com. That's WallStreetRaw.com.
This is George Norrie from Coast to Coast AM and History Channel's Ancient Aliens. We promote the amazing energy, nutrition, and skincare products from Jeunesse and invite you to try them today by visiting GCNLife.com. Jeunesse products are designed by leading doctors in their field with natural ingredients and even stem cell technology. These products help your body perform and look better. Jeunesse products have a 30-day money-back guarantee. Shop Jeunesse at GCNLife.com. That's GCNLife.com.
I'm David Hall, founder of Diamond Gusset, where we're proud of our 100% grown and sewn American-made jeans. Whether you're out for dinner, working on the farm, or on the road, Diamond Gusset Jeans offers a full spectrum of styles and sizes for any occasion. To find yours, visit gusset.com. That's G-U-S-S-E-T.com. Our loyal customers enable us to continue sponsoring Liberty Media outlets like the one you're listening to. In Liberty, David Hall, Diamond Gusset Jean Company.